Hello viewers, in this video lecture we are going to see the topic closure properties of CFL from the fourth unit of theory of computation. And the objectives are to understand the closure properties of CFL and to prove the closure properties of CFL. First of all, let us see what is meant by context-free languages. Context-free languages are languages which are accepted by pushdown automata. Normally, the context-free languages can be generated by context-free grammars. The grammar having the productions in the form of A tends to P, where A belongs to N and P belongs to T union N the whole power star. And N is a non-terminal and T is a terminal. Now, properties of context-free languages. First of all, union. If N1 and L2 are two context-free languages, their union, that is L1 union L2, will also be context-free proof. Let us have the example. The first language L1 equal to A power N, B power N, C power M. And our second language L2 is equal to A power N, B power M, C power M. And the union resultant language is called as L3. L3 is equal to L1 union L2, which will have the format A power N, B power N, C power M union A power N, B power M, C power M, which is also context free. So in L1, there is the number of A's should be equal to number of B's. In L2, the condition is the number of B's should be equal to number of C's. So their union, their resultant language says, should be either satisfy either of two conditions. So it is a context free language, that is the union of two languages will become the context free language. So we can say CFL is closed under union. And the second property is concatenation. If L1 and L2 are two context free languages, their concatenation L1.L2 will also be context free. Let us have the first language L1 equal to A power N, B power M. And our second language L2 equal to C power M, D power M. And the concatenation will be L3 equal to L1.L2. And the resultant language will be A power N, B power N, C power M, D power M, which will also be context free. L1 says number of A's should be equal to number of B's. And L2 says number of C's should be equal to number of D's. And the concatenation, the resultant language says first number of A's should be equal to number of B's, then number of C's should be equal to number of D's. So we can create a pushdown automata which will first push for A's, then pop for B's, push for C's, then pop for D's. So it can be accepted by pushdown automata. Hence the language will be context free. So we can say CFL, context free language, is closed under concatenation. Now lean closure. If L1 is context free, its lean closure L1 star will also be context free. For example, we will have the language L1 equal to A power N, B power N. Then L1 star will become A power N, B power N, the whole power star. So this is the resultant language after performing the lean closure operation. So the resultant language will also be context free. So CFL are closed under lean closure. Now we can see the properties intersection and complementation. If L1 and L2 are two context free languages, their intersection, that is L1 intersection L2, need not be context free. For example, if L1 equal to A power N, B power N, C power M, then L2 equal to A power M, B power N, C power N, then their intersection L1 intersection L2 is considered as L3, which need not be context free. So the intersection is, the CFL is not closed under intersection. The next one is complementation. The complementation of the context-free language also not closed under context-free. Okay. The complementation of the language L1 will be considered as dash L1 which own satisfy the properties of the PDA. So the complementation will not, the resultant of resultant language of the complement will not be the context free language. So CFL is not closed under complementation. So that's all about the properties of CFL. And the possible universal questions are, state and prove the closure properties of CFL. Thank you.